We're midway through the installation of an EV charger on this property here. As a homeowner, one of the most important decisions you have to make when choosing an EV charger is whether to go for a tethered option or an untethered option. But what does that actually mean? Well, in simplistic terms, a tethered charger has the lead that charges the car permanently attached to it. While an untethered, or sometimes called socketed charger, you have to provide that lead, or it may come with the car when you buy it. But in this video, we're going to look at some of the other factors that may lead you down the route of a tethered or untethered or socketed charger. Of course, there's no rules to suggest which one you should choose, but a lot of people start with aesthetics. And what will the charger look like on the front of your property? Because often the parking space faces the street, so you don't want to damage that all-important curb appeal. And this charger here certainly got a minimalist look. But what about when you've actually got to charge the car? You're going to have to insert your own lead into it, and those leads can look a little bit agricultural. It's really a question of convenience. How often are you going to be charging your car at home, and do you want to leave the lead permanently attached? Now, this is the lead that came with my car, and so it looks like a hose pipe. So you have your minimalist charger with this permanently connected to it. Doesn't look very attractive. Now, of course, an easy way to keep everything looking neat and tidy is to pack the charging lead away every time you've finished using it, and that can be a little bit of a challenge in terms of wrestling it back into the bag they're supplied with and stashing it in the boot of your car. But also think about weather. You know, if this charger's been dragging along the ground and it's that salt from the road, mud from the garden, that can also end up going all over your clothes every time you want to put it away. Of course, another reason for choosing a socketed charger could be the initial cost. At face value, they do appear cheaper than the tethered option. However, you will still have to provide the charging cable. You might be lucky it comes with the car, but if it doesn't, there can be quite an expensive option to buy. And if you're going to leave this cable permanently connected to the charger, you want to make sure nobody can remove it. Thankfully, most quality chargers have the option that this locks in place. You'll see there's a little tab in the top of the socket there that when it's inserted into the charger, can be permanently locked in place. And also remember, if you're relying upon the charging cable that was supplied by the car, you probably will need to take that with you, so you can actually charge when you're away from home. And I have been in an instance where I've forgotten to take this cable with me, and it's a major inconvenience. Some other reasons you may want to pick a socketed charger. Obviously, you've got lots of flexibility in terms of the charging lead length. You can change it to suit the exact needs of the car you have. It's also very easy to replace a lead should it become damaged. They're a good option for property developers who may want to offer EV charging as a feature to sell a property, but allow the end user lots of choice in terms of exactly how they go about it. Or this could be sitting on the property for years before they even adopt an EV car, so you may not want that charging lead hanging around. So now let's look at the tethered charger. This would be my personal preference, and that's based on 4 years of EV ownership. When I come home at night, I want that convenience of being able to quickly plug my car in and start charging. And remember, it could be dark, it could be raining. I don't want to be reaching into the back of the car to find that charging lead. Now, this charger here from Sync EV, it's a good looking unit, and it comes with an incredibly generous 7.5 meters of cable attached to it. Now, that's important because different cars have their socket on the body of the car that you plug into in different locations. So 7.5 meters allows you to drive in forwards or reverse in most instances. Some chargers come with shorter leads, so watch out for that based on the car that you're going to choose. This charger has been well designed to enable easy storage of the cable by simply winding it around the charger and clicking the plug into a holster when it's not in use. It's quite important to keep the charger neat and tidy, because the last thing you want is somebody reversing over the cable and damaging it, because then to replace that cable is expensive, and obviously need to get the cover off and possibly an electrician out to replace it. The EV owner here has decided to go for the tethered option for convenience. Are there any considerations that we've missed in this video that you think users should consider? Put them in the comments below. If you'd like to see the full process that we went through to install this BG Sync EV charger, hop over to our Red channel, where you can see the installation in this video here.